And now to a story you'll see only on WPBF 25 News. For the first time, we're hearing from a woman hit by a bullet during a shooting earlier this year at the Indian River State College campus.
Ted White spoke to that victim just minutes ago. He joins us live from her attorney's office in Seward with this exclusive interview. Ted?
Well, she says by all accounts, this has been a very tough experience. She's 22 years old, was supposed to graduate last May, but that has put on hold. She's still studying now and planning to graduate soon. Listen to her story.
I had a collapsed lung, fractures of the bullet went into my liver.
Ojeda is talking about surviving a very scary experience where she was a victim of a shooting. She spent a week in the hospital and months in therapy. Now, back in February, police say Nicozy McLean drove to the Fort Pierce home of a man and shot at that man. He ended up missing that man. He was a fellow Indian River State College student. Now, the two had been feuding since a run-in at the campus bookstore back in August. Now, police say McLean shot at them as he left that home and ended up at Indian River State College. Police shot McLean shot at him at the school, and Roxette Ojeda ended up getting shot on campus. She says it has been very tough trying to move on.
Even hearing a loud noise can sometimes trigger emotional responses, or going out to public places, sometimes I just feel very unsafe.
And the question that we ask ourselves over and over is, where was the security? Her class was in the building where law enforcement officers are trained. So you would think that's the safest area. But that, in fact, is where the shooting occurred.
And that was Ojeda's attorney, Barbara Kibbe. She says they are talking right now with people from the college and people from Fort Pierce Police right now. They have not filed a lawsuit. They said they are hoping that all parties involved in this will come to a conclusion in which they will not have to file a lawsuit. We'll have much more on this story coming up tonight at 6. Reporting live in Seward, Ted White, WPBF 25 News.